Hey, everybody, welcome to the Gym Master Show Live Entertainment Lifestyle Variety Talk Show Series. How's everybody doing today? It's so nice to see all your smiley faces. And if your faces are not smiling, well, you know that this is the place where by the time we're wrapped up with this show with our 2 hour goodbyes, our goodbyes are very long because we don't say goodbye. We just say see you later. But if you're not smiling today, we're going to make you smile with some fantastic conversation, poignant moments, lots of levity and laughs, and terrific live musical performances. That's right. Got a very special show in store. We're here on the East Coast of the United States in the New York area. Our guests are coming from the West Coast in Los Angeles, California. And when I say guests, well, we've got some special surprise bonus guests who are joining a very special guest, Kaylene Peoples, acclaimed vocalist, musician, composer, former Miss California as well, and extraordinary flautist. She's going to perform live, and we're going to be joined by, get this, in addition to Kaylene, who's extraordinary herself, fabulous voice, has a new CD out, a brilliant composer, lots of incredible scoring she's done. She is really, really extraordinary, an amazing talent. She's very excited because she has a new CD out too called Romantic Bossa Nova. And we're so excited about telling you about that and so much more that's going to be coming up. But there are two other incredible guests that are going to be joining and performing with her as well. I'm talking about renowned, acclaimed, two-time Grammy nominated jazz bassist Brunel is going to be with us, and renowned guitarist Joe Caldreron is going to be with us as well. They are legends, and they're going to be joining us here, and we're really, really excited about that. So we've got an amazing show that's coming up for all of you. Again, Bunny's going to be joining us. Yes, and Joe is going to be joining us along with Kaylene, and it's going to be absolutely an epic an epic conversation, an epic evening. There's Bunny and there is Joe. And of course, you know their music. And Kaylene is extraordinary. We're going to talk about her background in just a second and welcome her in just a second. She's getting all prepared. We just did a sound check. You know, sometimes when we have musical guests, we do sound checks. So we're just making sure audio and everything is all good because they're going to perform live right here exclusively on the Gym Master Show Live. How's everybody doing today? It's so good to see everybody. I see lots of comments already built up in our JMS Live chat room, which is really awesome. We have an international audience who watches the Gym Master Show Live. If this is your first time here, we welcome you. I work in television and radio and stage and film professionally, and we started the Gym Master Show Live Entertainment Lifestyle Variety Talk Show Series. It's about 2 years ago. It's over 2 years ago now, and we've done some 700 episodes live just about 7 days a week, which is extraordinary, with guests who do come in from Broadway, Hollywood, television, film, music, stage, sports, comedy, culinary arts, inspiration, and everything else you can think of. Life in general, living life well. So we're so excited. Now, if you would like to comment while the show is live. Now I'm talking to those who are watching live right now, because I know many of you also watch these episodes later on when the show is not live. And if you're watching this later on, we welcome you as well. Leave a comment on our YouTube channel. Let us know how much you're enjoying our series and the guests and the conversation and all the things we do here. But for those who are watching live right now, if you would like to comment in our exclusive JMS Live chat room, guess what? You can do that when you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is the channel you happen to be watching right now. So we kind of make that really easy for you. If you would like to chat in the chat room right now, a lot of our viewers, they chat amongst themselves. They say hi. They sort of know each other through our incredible show in our series. And then sometimes we take a look at some of your comments as well. The guests see the comments. If you would like to support what we're doing in this series, you can do super emoji, super stickers, super chat. That's available when the show is live, or at any time you can click the little heart icon that's on every episode of our series. That's the super thanks icon. And that helps support all the work, all the content, all the hours that it takes to put this series together, which is like a full-time situation on many levels. But we're so excited again to invite you to chat in that chat room live if you'd like when you subscribe to the YouTube channel. Now, really, all you have to do is click that red button right there. You see it on the YouTube channel, right? It says subscribe. It's right there at the head of the channel, right on the top of the channel. Now, there's no cost for that. When you click that, magic happens. You'll be part of our JMS Lovety Squad or Lovety family. That means to us, you really appreciate what we're doing. It also helps our channel build and grow and expand, which then helps us to deliver. When you hit subscribe, it also helps us to be able to deliver more content as well as reach more people. So if you like what we're doing here, definitely show us that you do by clicking subscribe. We would love that. There's no cost for that. And make sure you click the notification bell as well. It's a little bell icon you see next to that red subscribe button. Now, when you click the notification bell, what happens is you're notified about all the episodes, so you never miss. Sometimes we have, you know, a viewer that'll say, oh, I didn't know they were on. I didn't know you were on. I didn't know you were doing a pop-up show. I didn't know you were doing a holiday theme show. Oh, I didn't know that was the guest. Well, because there's a little icon there, looks like a bell, next to the subscribe button. When you click that, you receive like a little alert. Coming up on the Gym Masters show, this is what we're going to be doing. So you'll never miss out, because I know many of you like to be here when the show is live, so you can sort of participate and activate. And we like to be interactive with our guests as well as our viewers. So definitely check that out and check everything out. And again, they're going to be coming from Los Angeles in just a second. We're really, really excited to have them here. First, I want to tell you a little bit about the guests. Now, again, I see a lot of comments here as well already. That is fantastic. We welcome everybody. Keep those comments coming. It's really fantastic to have all of you here. And also, thanks to those of you who have been writing us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook at Gym Masters TV, and also in our Facebook group, the Gym Masters Show, Lovety Hall. We appreciate all of that activity and all the lovety and everything that you guys have been expressing as far as how this series really touches you. Were you with us last night? Last night we had Melissa Manchester as our very special guest, and it was the second visit for Melissa, and she was talking about her Live 77 album, which was really cool. That just came out. It was unreleased music from back in 77. That the label didn't release and now is being released all these years later, which is really amazing. Some others too. Joanna Gleason was here recently. Leland Sklar was with us. He was extraordinary. Lucy Arnez was with us recently as well. Just some of the guests who have stopped by Lovety Hall here and the Gym Masters Show live. A quick programming note as well. I want to let you know it's very exciting, and we were just chatting with them today as well. So check out the episode with Melissa Manchester. She was with us yesterday. Coming up tomorrow, Tony Orlando is with us. Yes. And he's all excited, and we're all excited. He's going to really spread the sunshine, as Tony has for many years. Grammy-nominated gold and platinum-selling music legend and entertainer Tony Orlando stopping by the Gym Masters Show tomorrow. John Davidson is going to be with us as well. You know John, of course. This will be his second visit here on our show, actually. Legendary TV and game show host, Hollywood Squares. That's incredible. So many great shows he's been a part of. And, of course, a great singer, songwriter, actor, and lots more. And also coming up in a future show, Barbara Brighton is going to be with us, legendary comedian, Las Vegas entertainer, and she's known for the Joan Rivers impressions that she does, which are extraordinary. But we are so excited again to welcome Kaylene Peoples to the show and crew, because again, Bunny and Joe are here as well. And I want to tell you just a little bit about her extraordinary background. There is Bunny, and there is Joe, and they are joining us as well. Kaylene is really an extraordinary performer. She's so passionate. She's so talented, and she's just absolutely spectacular. We had such a great conversation on the phone last night. I think we chatted for about maybe 2 hours, just we were talking about the show and what we were going to do and everything, but we ended up just talking about life. Kaylene Peoples is what you call a quadruple threat. Now, if you're wondering what that means, well, she was a runway model, a former Miss California. She's a vocalist with a rare 5-octave range, a multi-instrumentalist, a prolific composer, arranger, conductor. She graduated from UCLA with a Bachelor of Arts in composition and so much more. I mean, she completed an elite master's program in film scoring too, under the direction of Academy Award-winning composer Walter Scharf. She also studied with Academy Award-winning composers David Raskin and the one and only Henry Mancini. And I'm excited to let you know that coming up soon, Henry's daughter, Monica Mancini, and her husband, Greg Field, who are dear friends of mine. I interviewed Monica on PBS television. You guys know I work with PBS. They're going to be coming on the show in a matter of weeks. But she studied with Henry Mancini. And Kaylene also even played piano side by side with Oscar winner film composer Jerry Goldsmith. She's written and conducted countless string arrangements for record labels, including Capitol Records, Polygram, Warner Brothers, EMI, and Universal and Republic. Her dossier doesn't just stop there. She has written huge bodies of musical works, including neoclassical symphonies, and composed and conducted a 10-act ballet as well. Her orchestration skills can be heard on several movie soundtracks, including American Pie 2, Serendipity, Ruby, and her own multi-award-winning feature film she directed, Redemption. She's also an award-winning Los Angeles Music Awards producer for Best R&B Album of the Year and Best New Artist, Christina Fasano's Spiritually Wet. This is just the short list, folks. Her first jazz CD, All Jazzed Up, made a splash across the nation when her single, Do You Remember, was played all across the country. The single climbed to the top of the independent charts. Her newest CD, My Man, made quite an impression as well on jazz lovers through the airwaves and in concert. And since that release, it has been repeatedly number one on the Reverb Nation jazz charts and remains in the top 40 as well. And also, too, as I mentioned, she was also on the ballot for the Grammys, too. In addition to that, there is the new album that we're talking about, which is really, really exciting. And this is something that is really near and dear to her heart because she's been working on this a long time, and it's right here. It's Romantic Bossa Nova. And you got to hear this. You got to pick this up. You got to grab this. We'll tell you how you can get it. You know, of course, all the usual places, the Spotify's, the Amazon's, the iTunes, and everything else. I also wanted to know, she also has this wonderful organization that celebrates women composers. And I think that's fantastic. It's called Bella Composers. I mean, like I said, she is a real go-getter. She's got her hands in a lot of different things. The premier performing arts platform celebrating women composers. We're going to talk about that as well. And she also editor of a phenomenal magazine, Agenda. Yeah. She is, like I said, she's a go-getter and she has a lot of incredible things that she's involved in. We'll talk about all of that and more, but it is, again, my pleasure to welcome her to the show. Live and direct from Los Angeles, California, again, as well. Keep the comments coming, everybody. I see lots of comments here. Good to see everybody. Hello to all the JMS lovities that are watching around the world. Let's welcome Kaylene and the gang to the Jim Master Show live again, live and direct from Los Angeles, California. You guys ready? Because we are ready to go. And this is going to be exciting. Here we go. Yay! Hey, Kaylene, how are you? Welcome. There you are. Welcome. Nice to see you. Yes, we see Bunny and we see Joe. How are you guys?
So are we all being seen?
Right now, all three are seen, yes.
It's not cut off?
No, it's all three. We see, yeah, we see all three. Nobody's cut off. How you doing, Kaylene? Welcome.
I am fine and very excited to be on your show.
I appreciate that.
Thank you for inviting me.
Oh, the pleasure is all mine. Now, you have been not only now a guest on our show, but you've been a lovety, a Gym Master Show lovety viewer. You've been watching some of the episodes of the series, right? That makes you a real lovety.
Yes.
And you've been enjoying?
I have. It's been awesome, really. It's great.
I appreciate that. So how have you been? You know, it's been crazy times the last couple of years, and it's like things are starting to open up, people getting busy again, venues sort of opening. How have you been over the last couple of crazy years?
Well, you know, COVID really, the pandemic itself really just threw everybody off, especially musicians, I'm going to just be honest. We've had to learn how to reinvent ourselves, and I think that we've done that pretty well. But it has been a challenge. We, you know, tours got canceled and trying to get our footing back. You know, it's aside from that, based on all the facts that we, many of us are so creative, we ended up doing our own projects during the pandemic, which in a way that was a good thing.
Right. Yeah. Exactly. Everybody's had to find ways to adapt and to, but you have been, busy recording and creating music throughout it all. Right. And you have this new spectacular album, Romantic Bossa Nova, and congratulations on that. Tell us about some of the cool things that you've been doing during all of this crazy downtime. You haven't stopped. You've got everything going.
Well, as soon as just before the pandemic hit, we did a CD release concert in 2020 for Romantic Bossa Nova. Which ended up becoming quite the show that I've been doing for the last really year and a half. It features me, and obviously me, on flute and vocal, mostly vocals on this. And Bunny is actually a co-star on the album. Bunny Brunel is a co-star on the album. And we also have a beautiful lineup for the actual show itself, the live show. My guitarist, Joe, plays in the live show. He's playing solo on one of the tunes, which is called Waters of March, so that's really cool. I was doing a lot of gigging really up until, I guess the last gig we did was, what was the last gig we did? Was that March? That was March. Anyway, I think the last gig we like officially did was in March. We have some coming up. But, I also debuted a song from Romantic Bossa Nova on the Artemis International Film Festival, which also happened post maybe about 3 months after the pandemic hit, and that was kind of exciting. But mostly, thank you for that amazing intro, by the way.
My pleasure. And that was just the abbreviated version.
I know what's really interesting about this question is I shot a film and that's going to supposedly, it's planned to be released in the end of this year. It's called Accidental Squatter. I'm a director, producer, and it stars an up-and-coming actress named Lee Bush and Chase Masterson. Leader from Deep Space Nine is actually co-starring in it. Ali Song from Argo is co-starring in it. And of course, I'm scoring that as well. That's probably the big thing that I have coming up. That it's in the can. We're just in post-production right now with that.
You know, that's a whole other thing, too. The fact that you do scoring, which is a spectacular area of music. How did you get into scoring? What was the inspiration? What was the entree into doing that kind of work in music for you, Kaylene?
I always knew that I wanted to compose music. As a child, I would really watch movies. I was a kid watching movies, and I would be like, I kind of like how they did that music. Or I'm like a little kid saying this. And then I discovered there was actually a career in that. And so from there, my whole music career started as a child, and composing was a very big part of it. I studied with some big people, as you mentioned. I'm just one of those crazy people who has music always going on in my head, and I've got to get it out on paper, otherwise it would drive me crazy. So it makes me a little prolific. But I would say it's just something that was sort of planted inside me as a child. I think I was kind of born that way, you know?
Yeah. What were the early influences for you when you were a kid? Were there those that you admired that were in the industry, certain musicians, vocalists, others in the industry that you really enjoyed, that sort of inspired you along the way?
Yeah, definitely. On the classical side, and that's the wrong word, it's really 19th century music. I loved 19th century music. Chopin was a really big influence in my life. Chopin, and then of course I loved Shostakovich. And you're gonna hear a lot of my music has a combination of 19th century romanticism and maybe early 20th century. Even Wagner, put the politics aside, but I'm a big fan of Wagner as well. And so you, as a composer, that can be heard in a lot of my orchestral music. On a side note, we'll talk about this. As I said, 19th century is something that I really like, and I have composed a tune. And that tune that I composed on the piano was my talent piece for the Miss Anaheim pageant, the Miss America system. And that piece is probably critical to me winning that pageant. Of course, moving into the state pageants and things like that. So.
Wow, that's amazing. That really is amazing. Are you a vocalist before you are a musician, or are you a musician who is a vocalist? What speaks to your heart and soul first? Some say one versus the other, some say it's equal. Are you a vocalist before you are the musician, or vice versa? How does it work for you, Kaylene?
I'm a musician first because that was really my first love, and I didn't even know I could sing until I was really in college. I didn't even know. Someone just heard me and they were like, oh my gosh, are you singing? I'm like, no, I'm not a composer. So I would say that I'm an instrumentalist, musician, composer, arranger, conductor first, and I sort of stepped into the vocal side of things later.
When did people really start to notice your extraordinary talent? What would you say was one of those pivotal open the door moments for you where people said, wow, she's a multi-talented person here? When did that really start to happen for you, Kaylene?
That's a very hard question. Well, I think probably the beauty pageants, I would do a thing where I was performing and either fluting or performing it. Like, for instance, when I was in the Miss California pageant, Miss America system, California pageant, I played Flight of the Bumblebee and Rolling Tell Overture on the piano that I had also arranged the arrangement for the orchestra. And that was when people really were kind of like, whoa. And that for me was like a walk in the park. I wasn't even thinking anything about that. and I didn't even know that was such a big deal. And then when I was in college, somebody heard me singing and asked me if I would participate in like a program they were doing. It was just one little like show or whatever. And it was so small, it wasn't even a big deal, but I ended up blowing people out of the water on that one, and I didn't even know that I really, you know, I just mimicked people at first. I could sing like Mariah Carey tunes and all kinds of, you know, Whitney Houston tunes, and it was like, wow, you really have a good voice. So that's when I started moving into the voice part of things. That's when I realized that, oh, maybe I should be doing this, you know. Because people would think anyway, they would see me, they'd go, oh, are you a singer?
Right.
I would never get, oh, are you a composer?
Right.
I never got that.
Was the flute the very first instrument for you? And are you a multi-instrumentalist? Can you play other instruments as well? I mean, you are incredible on the flute. Gang, if you have not heard her do her thing, once you hear it, you're hooked. But was the flute the first for you? And what is it about the flute that really speaks to your heart, Kaylene?
The flute was the first thing for me. When I attended my sister's concert when I was, I think it was like five, clarinet or something. And I go, oh, that's a pretty instrument. The flute was really pretty, right?
Yeah.
And so I was like, oh, I want to play that. Because, you know, you want to be like your older sibling. It's like, you know, you want to follow in their footsteps. So I picked up the flute and that's my first instrument. I started playing that at nine. And
I've
never
been
down.
At nine, really? That's fantastic. So,
you know.
Yeah. So, you have been at it for quite a while, and you've just continued to grow as a musician and as a vocalist in so many different ways. This particular album, Romantic Bossa Nova. I love Bossa Nova music. What was it about wanting to dip into the Bossa Nova world for you that also spoke to you?
Okay, this is going to be a very funny story. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I was on a cruise, okay? And this is really funny. Okay, I wasn't always blonde. And I had dark brown hair, and the captain of the cruise, they came over to my table and asked me to sit at the captain's table. So I was like, wow, these people are like super nice.
That's cool, huh? Captain's table.
And so when the day before the cruise was going to end, I was walking in the purser's office, and then one of the people comes running up to me and he goes, what's your name? You have a bet going. I'm like, oh, it's Kaylene. They're like, oh, I lost the bet. I was like, what are you talking about? They said, the guy goes, we thought you were this famous Brazilian singer. You look just like her. I was like, oh, okay. I could work with that. I could use that. I said, you know? Huh. And so I did. I intended to do a jazz song. My first jazz album was all jazz stuff, and I attempted Brazilian Portuguese on Girl from Ipanema, and of course I had a coach and everything, and that was great. But of course I sounded like an American, you know, singing Portuguese. But that pretty much got me started because they assumed I was anyway when they saw me, you know, that I was Brazilian-ish, whatever, and I said, you know, I started listening to a lot of the music, and I was sort of fell in love with it, like Joe Beam. I'm just in love with Antonio Carlos Jobim and some of the other, Sergio Mendes, and some of the other, you know, like, what's the one, it's something, well, Brazil 66, things like that, like, oh, just beautiful music, and plus the simplicity in the lyrics. It's very simple, but it's also very carefully structured and put together, but it's simple, but it really holds it in heart. And when I recorded, when I did a live performance, my CD release concert I did on the first album, All Jazz Step, people were really moved by the bossa nova. Like, it seemed to just move them. It didn't matter what I'm saying. And so Romantic Bossa Nova sort of is an incarnation of all of those experiences. And I decided we could do an album called Romantic Bossa Nova because it doesn't matter the song. I mean, because just all of them are amazing. And the audience response and just looking at their reaction, it's something magical about that music to me.
Yeah.
And I love it. It's just great.
Yeah, it, I agree. Absolutely. It really, really is. We have a, we have actually a little clip. It's only about 45 seconds, but it's you and the gang doing Cocovado, and it's really terrific. And it's a, we want to play this, and fingers crossed with YouTube, but we're going to give it a shot. We'll give it a shot. It's only 47 seconds, but it's just enough of a tiny little tease for the viewers just to hear Kaylene doing her thing, because they're going to perform live. If you're just joining us, Jim Masters here. Welcome to the Jim Masters Show, Love, Entertainment, Lifestyle, Variety Talk Show Series. Kaylene Peoples is here. Bonnie Brunel is here. Joe Caldreron is here, too. They're all positioned and poised, one with the bass, one with the guitar. They're ready to go. And first, we want to play this little clip for all of you. Thanks for all the great comments. You're welcoming them to our show. Lovities watching around the world. Keep the comments coming. We have folks viewing from the United States, Canada, Europe, Asia, Africa, Australia, New Zealand, Canada, South America, Brazil, Argentina. Really nice. Welcome to everybody. Here's a little clip of some incredible music as Kaylene does her thing in this clip. And then we'll be back with Kaylene and the guys in just a second on the Jim Masters Show.
Eu conheci o que me feliz do jeito
Talk about a tease, gang. Doesn't that make you want much more? That is, I love that sound. I love that kind of music. I collect all of that. I collect bossa nova. I've got lots of jazz. I've got smooth jazz. I've got easy listening, beautiful music like Henry Mancini. I mean, literally all of it. We actually have here a storage unit we pay monthly for that's filled with sealed records, LPs, cassettes, reel-to-reels, lots of them too, preserved with the family photos and all of my work from television and radio in this climate-controlled bin that we pay monthly for to preserve it all. And that's such a great sound. Tell us about that particular clip. It was beautifully shot too. Whoever did the camera work, they did a beautiful job capturing the movements of the camera along with the feeling and vibe of the music.
You know what? Thank you for recognizing the film part of it. Videographer is Andy Gavazos, and he was using 6K and 4K cameras, and then we had a third camera with the 4K as well. Thank you for that. That's what inspired that. We recorded that at SIR. It was a live taping at SIR. And Joe Caldreron, you probably saw him on the guitar on there. We had Maheshwar Surya on piano. Percussionist was John Brooks. And the drummer is Brian Cabrera. And of course, Bunny Brunel and myself.
Tell us about the, I mentioned a little bit about them in the introduction, but you have two incredible gentlemen, one to the left, one to the right, who are incredibly talented, beloved, acclaimed, all of those words that we all use, but you work with them, you perform with them, you create with them. Tell us, for the audience tuning in, about Bunny and his fabulous background, and then introduce us also to Joe and his background as well.
Okay, Bunny, can I speak for you? Okay, I'm going to speak for you, and I'm going to talk about Bunny. Bunny Brunel.
He's like, am I on?
Bunny is probably the most. I'm going to say it. This is my opinion. He's the best bass player and then come in his band and use a line and it's real and honor. But he has played with everybody from Chick Corea to Tony Williams to Jeff DeJohnette to Stevie Wonder, Natalie Cole, and then also there's a whole French side of him where he's performed and not just performed but music directed with famous musicians also on the European side, Joachim Stocking, Tanya Maria, what is the name of the Paul, Michel Ponera, but the list is endless. Wayne Shorter and Herbie Hancock. It's endless. But Buddy is, he's got two Grammy nominations, one with Chick Corea for Secret Agent, correct?
Yes.
And then with his own band, Cab, Cab 2, right? Yeah, it's Cab 2 with Tony McAlpine and Dennis Chambers. And he's just the top of the food chain, fusion. And just, I'm in awe. And I'm in awe to even be allowed to be on the same musical stage with him. I'm just, he's amazing. So that's Buddy Brunel. And then there's Joe Caldreron, who I just love Joe. He's an incredible guitar player. And he's also a dedicated musician. He's like just dedicated. He's very good at what he does too. He plays beautiful electric guitar and beautiful nylon. And I even dig his flamenco because he does a cool little. But he's very loyal. And he has a new record out called Cup of Joe. What is the name of your label? He's with Warrior Records, and he's put out other things too. Like, what was the last thing that you did? Yeah, We'll Be Together Again. There's that. You'll be able to find those things online. Yeah, he's got
killer. This is a killer name. Yeah,
I love it. I'll have a cup of joe. With a little bit of whiskey in it. But yeah, you think. Name some of the people. Oh, Diane Reeves. He's played with Diane Reeves. Name some of the people. Billy Childs. Okay. Gloria Trevi. Gloria Trevi, like the Madonna of Mexico. Yeah, just as he's just a long list of just an intense background. You know? And it's an honor to play with Joe.
That's fantastic. Welcome to Joe and welcome to Bunny and welcome to Dr. Cindy Banton. Hello, cousin Kaylene. So proud of you. She's watching. She's now a Gym Master Show lovety here on the show. I want to mention too, in addition to the phenomenal music, Merlin in Canada asked this question. She goes, was the flute your talent when you were running for Miss California? So what was the flute part of, you know, when you were presenting yourself for that contest, when they do have, you know, the competitions and the talent portion of that, was the flute used for that?
So, yes, the flute, the actual city pageant, it was a classical piece that I had which was on piano, but when I got into the state pageant, I played flute and piano, Flag of the Bumblebee, Rosal Overture, and it was part of my talent, yes. And I just want to clarify, that's not my Miss, okay, so the Miss America system is not my Miss California, it's Miss
right.
Young Miss is what I'm Miss California for, and I have another pageant title from this Golden State. So I have two state pageant titles, and those I also did flute and vocal. I always did flute and vocal together, and that's kind of what blew people away.
It is, when even in that little clip that we just showed, you go from singing in the middle of a sentence, then you pick up the flute, and people are probably like, what?
Yeah.
Now, you've been described, as I said, as a quadruple threat, which is, I think, pretty cool because of all the things you've done and continue to do, which is really, really something special. I want to make mention, definitely, a couple of other things that I think are very important that people know about you. In addition to, you know, your brilliant vocal prowess and musicianship and talent as a composer and everything else, and being surrounded by, you know, these legends, Joe and Bunny, you are doing some other things that really pay it forward and inspire and uplift others. I really love the idea of the Bella Composers, celebrating women composers. Tell us about your involvement in that. That's something very special.
So Bella Composers came about as, because I'm a woman, female composer, and when I was coming up, I did plenty of orchestration, and I did plenty of, I did a ton of ghost writing. I mean, there were some major TV shows that I'm the one that did the ghost writing for, you know, nighttime TV shows. But I could never get a score. And if I did do the scores, they were always independent projects. And it just seemed like it was very difficult as a woman to, at the time, it was unheard of. Like, it was absurd. What am I doing composing, right? So I kind of put my music up on, my composing music up on the shelf for a minute, because I was never going to abandon it. But I was waiting just for the right opportunity to finally do something where I could not only reemerge as a composer, but also help other women composers, because I quickly discovered that there was a lot of women who were just like me, writing symphonies and ballets and just like me, and nobody was giving them any attention, no one would give them any chance or opportunity unless they wanted them an arranger, you know, an orchestrator, or a ghostwriter, you know, or a transcriber. Those were the only jobs you could get as a woman. So in 2015, in correspondence with my dual release concert that I did with Buddy Brunel, we did a dual CD release concert. He was doing Invent Your Future. I was doing My Nan. And Patrice Rushen was a guest performer on our show. And she's also a composer. She decided, we all put the show together, and it was a launch for Bella Composers. And the launch did really, really well. And recently, in 2018, I was asked to come on board of a company called Artemis Women in Action Film Festival. And I was working with them on another capacity. And they discovered that I was, a musician composer. And in fact, the director, Melanie Wise, the following year, in 2019, they approached me about my composing company doing a special kind of award show for composers. And I was thrilled, and it was literally the first of its kind. We had women, it's called Women Powered Music, sponsored by Bella Composers. And we had women submitting their symphonies and scores, and what's special about my company is, you know, you can buy a keyboard and sequencer, and you can actually come up with a lot of things, you know, you don't have to have any knowledge, but I wanted to see the scores. I wanted to see that the person had the knowledge and the education, not just get a sequencer and write something. I want to, like, old school, you know. And these women were submitting their scores, and they were beautifully written. I was so blown away. A lot of their symphonies and orchestral pieces were performed, like, in all over the world. From Australia to Russia to Japan to Canada. I was just blown away. And they came out from all over the world just to be part of it. Like, they showed up at the event for the award shows and everything. And this went on. I was able to do it in 2019 and 2020, and then the pandemic kind of stopped the award show. But a lot of people ended up being finally the recognition they deserve. And that's kind of what Delicate Poems is about, because I don't care how old you are. If you're 100 years old and you wrote a symphony, or you wrote a string arrangement or whatever, or if you're 18 and you wrote something, it's like, I don't care. I don't care the background. It doesn't matter. It just matters that you're a woman, and it just matters that you, this is something that you've devoted your life to. And the idea is to get these women placed on films so that they can actually start getting some kind of a real pedigree. You know, like we're talking, like, I'm talking studio films. I'm not even talking independent. I'm talking studio films. I pitched it to the chairman of Congress in Culver City. Mm. And they were so enthralled by the idea. The board members had no idea we were even existed. And so that's a very burning passion of mine. Like, it's something that I want to continue. I'm sad that the pandemic sort of stopped a lot of it, because we were on a roll. We were moving, and people were starting to notice these women, and they're still doing things. They're still doing great things. But this was a machine that was pushing them into the forefront. We were doing all the PR, making sure that people knew who they were. And that's what Delicate Poems is about. Because everything that encompasses me is probably as I'm a composer. You know?
Yeah.
That's why I choose the repertoire I choose, because I like the compositions. I'm like anal about it.
Right.
But it all boils down to the integrity of music, and the fact that even now I can count on one hand how many women are actually getting blockbuster films. They're I had a situation where I was hired to do orchestration on a major film, and I was very excited about it, and I didn't want to get paid. I just wanted the credit. And even though we had a contract and everything, it didn't happen, and it was devastating, because you don't get those opportunities at all. And that was kind of when I kind of hung my shoes up there for a minute, and I said, okay, I will figure this out. And it did take a long time, but yes, Bunny was a big part of, he's actually on the board. He's on the board. But he's a big part of me launching Bella, because we were able to do it with the CD release.
Really fantastic, you know, kudos to you. It's really a beautiful thing to, it inspires, empowers, and lifts others up, pays it forward in a very glorious way. You're also involved in this magazine too, Agenda. Tell us about this. I mean, as if your day is not already full, my friend.
Okay, so that's Agenda Magazine, and we have, it's been around for a long time. I started it in 2004, and it came out of my love for wanting to have a magazine when I was in high school. I always wanted to have a magazine. I would read all the Vogue and 17 and all the news and success. And so it's another one of those bucket list things. I said, okay, I'm going to do this. And I was the first, Agenda was the first magazine. We started online, and we were the first to stream video for a magazine online and do documentary-style interviews, because I was a film producer, so I had over 200 documentary-style interviews with some major director, major designers and people of the fashion industry, and some of them had even aired on national TV.
Wow.
We decided to go print in 2014, where we were putting out special edition, sort of like timeline books type things. And then we went regular print in 2017. So here we are in 2022, and ready to put out issue number 18.
Wow. Congratulations on that, huh? Congratulations. That's cool stuff. So lots of irons in the fire for you, Kaylene, that's really fantastic. Did you guys want to grace us with a song?
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Yeah, what would you like to do?
We're going to do, let me get Oh, no, not Joe. Okay, so we're doing a cut from Romantic Bossa Nova called Baron Hound.
Very nice. Kaylene, Bunny, and Joe, live on the Gym Master Show Live.
Salve, que me mucho que je ne vais pas, que je
Asian Georgia, Cyrano, Saban, More, Serbia, Mani, Kushta, Neora, Kinanda, Eotaba, Kina, Tinka, Puero, Kimo, Beka, Kabe, Burumbao, 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 Capoeira, Mina, Do, Jose, Keja, Shiku, Jeku, Haru, Taru. Bell bow, become them, fighting, regarding war, dress days and form it up.
Love that. That was excellent. Thanks, gang. Fantastic. Tell us about that song, Kaylene.
Okay, so that song, the buzzer has escaped my mind, but it's about an instrument. It's about an instrument, and it's kind of like a hero. Yeah.
And then eating it with a stick and then bang.
It's such a tonal instrument, and the song was written quite a long time ago, and then it's been recorded a few times, but that song, I just love the I love the groove of it, number one, and learning it phonetically was really fun. That was fun.
That had to be, yeah.
But it's another incredible bossa nova, one of the top bossa nova tunes. I like to record things that haven't been done too much.
Right.
And so that was something that was a little bit obscure, but it still did have a record of being recorded by a few artists. So I wish I could remember the name of the lady that inspired me to actually record it. Her name is Helen. Can't remember her last name, sorry, but that's the song. And so I decided to throw that on. It was one of my favorites. And I said, I'm going to show people that I can actually pronounce Portuguese. In fact, I have a funny story with that song. I would love to know. This lady came to the CD release concert we did in 2020. And because of my very first jazz album, all jazzed up, and I did Girl Pipanina, and I am singing interesting in Portuguese, but I sound American. She came up to me, it was so cute, and she goes, I'm here to see your show, and I'm a coach, and I can coach you on Portuguese, and I bought a ticket, and maybe after the show we can talk. I'm like, okay, sure. And so I did the first set, and I came up, I saw her, and she goes, you don't need lessons, and then she walked. So like that was like what? Okay, I've arrived. I got
that's it.
It. So, you've that was the song. Okay, I'm
you've made it. You've made it, right? That is funny. Now that song is on the new album.
Yes, it's on the Romantic Bossa Nova album, and it's on the track list here. Yeah. I do quite a few really cool tunes on that album.
Tell us about the album. Tell us about some of the songs that are on it that people can enjoy.
Okay, well, one will be an easy find for people is I'm on a website called Fortify, which is a huge deal to get on. And they took my Gingy alt version, which is another very big popular song, a very popular bossa nova tune, and they corded it on Fortify. So that's there. And then, of course, there's Corcovado, which we played earlier, Quiet Nights at Quiet Stars. I do another tune called Telephone Song, which Astrid Gilberto made famous.
Yeah.
And then another singer named Laura Fiji, I don't know if you've heard of her, she's called Bossa Nova. She made that very popular as well. Another tune, in French, I actually do Bessie Mucho.
Oh, wow.
aside from that, got some other cute songs like Watch What Happens, some Sergio Mendes style tunes are in there as well.
Very cool.
It's a pretty fun listen, and it's a good drive. It's a good driving song, you know, driving CD. So.
One of the hardest things is narrowing down, right? Everybody I know when they're making albums or CDs is you start with all these songs and then you have to narrow it down and pick only a certain amount that can actually fit on the album. Is that hard to decide what songs are going to be on the finished product to sort of deduce it and bring it down?
Yes.
Yeah. Because you want them all on there. Yeah.
Yeah, I've never done. Especially if I'm doing other, you know, if I'm doing covers. I do have albums from the original album. Everything that I always just listen to all different versions of the chords. Because I don't like to repeat an arrangement. I always like to have my own version of the arrangement so I can kind of make it my own. And that way it's recognizable as my own instead of just singing like a standard that is out of a fake book, yeah, everybody sings, you know, kind of the same way. I always like to add arrangements, but it's always complicated, yeah. There's a couple songs that didn't make it. They didn't make it on the album, I threw them out. They just didn't cut it, you know, like, how does it make you feel? It's not making you feel good, get rid of it. That's kind of like my, if it's not grooving, get rid of it. So those are types of, and sometimes you have to kind of record them all the way through to find out.
Right.
You're like killing your own babies.
You got to test the waters, test it out, and see if it matches the vibe of the rest of the album. Absolutely. And you have a good deal of music that is out, right? Which I think is really, really fantastic. Lots of good stuff that, you know, we've been looking at as we go along here. Look at this song. Look at this photo. That's a cool one. Do you remember where that was taken?
Yes, I'm actually glad you put that one up. That is from the Pop Culture Hero Coalition launch, and that is Chase Masterson, leader from Deep Space Nine, Star Trek. She is the face of a charity that is an anti-bullying charity, and this was the launch, and I was invited to sing a couple of tunes on that, and out of that concert, there are two singles, Beautiful and Beautiful and Imagine. Mm. I included that made it onto her compilation, CD compilation. And it's a great cause. This is a great cause. It's really helping children. Children get bullied so badly, and she's so passionate about helping these children, and that's what she does most of the time. She's backed by United Nations, and it's a big deal, and that's what was from that. That was a Fitello's, before it was Fine Signs of Films, before that, 2017,
I think. Cool.
Yeah, that was a fun concert.
Look at this one.
Oh, that's Alva's Showroom. It was my first Alva's Showroom. That I ever did in 2017, and we did a lot of straight ahead jazz. Of course, that's Virgil Donati. Okay, because I'm looking at it this way, so I'm hoping it's correct. Virgil Donati on the far left, and Mahesh Golisaria, and then of course that's me in the middle. Bunny Brunel, of course, and that's Joe Caldreron on the far right.
What a great group, huh? A lot of talent there. Wow.
Stupid talent.
Yeah, I was going to say. Packed with talent there. Absolutely. And we have some other things we wanted to show, too. This is one of Joe's as well, huh? The Mojo Love song.
Oh, I want to talk about it?
He didn't know he was going to be on.
Yes, on
that. Oh, okay. No, that's I dig that tune. It's kind of bluesy, jazzy, really heartfelt.
Yeah.
You are talking about Mojo Love song, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a cool one. I love this too. We showed this earlier.
So Cup of Joe, that's
the latest release.
And what's your single on that? Do you have a single on that?
Right. You mentioned Kaylene Chase Masterson. So there's this, huh?
Yes, that is actually the artwork for the back of the Pop Culture Hero Coalition compilation CD that she did.
That is cool.
A lot of great people.
There's another Agenda album. Magazine cover. Those magazine covers are really, really spectacular for Agenda.
You
know, very glossy and really, really nice. Here's another photo we have. Look at this one.
Now, Schmooze Jazz is a new magazine. I'm the executive editor, founder of it. And we just launched this. This is the new issue. The first issue with Dave Kaz, obviously.
Dave Kaz, yeah.
Called Schmooze Jazz, so we can schmooze while we talk about jazz.
that is so cool. Look at this one.
That is baseball, Buddy Brunel's historical CD that features bass players. It's a really incredible thing. I played flute on it, but it says on the list, but we've got some crazy people on there, like Adrian. Obviously Stanley Clark. He did this with Stanley Clark. You want to talk about this?
Yes, it's an album we decided to do with Stanley Clark. And it was going to be Stanley Clark for his record company. He didn't agree with it, because he had a new record company. So I made it Buddy Brunel with Stanley Clark, but we invited a bunch of great bass players. That's what he called me baseball.
Fantastic. Really cool. Here's another one too. Fusion Holidays.
Oh, okay.
So we decided to do that and invite a different bass player from different places, and I've been playing. And it worked great. It sounds great. Everybody brought some new ideas. And we just finished Baseball 2. Same idea with Stanley and inviting all those bass players from all over the world.
Wow.
So working on the problem right now.
Yeah.
So that's going to be the same type of thing.
And that's, okay, Fusion Holidays is the new single that Bunny just put out. Well, it's not even a month old, right?
Yes.
Yeah, it's about a month old. And it features a Russian guitarist named Roman Mironishchenko, who's famous over there. And it was born out of the fact that we were supposed to go on tour in Russia, and it kept getting postponed and postponed and postponed. And then he said, oh, let's do a single to support the tour. But he basically composed, produced this beautiful thing. And it features, obviously stars Bunny Brunel, features Roman, the guitarist, and then also featured would be Mahesh Villasaria is on this as well, and me, right? Am I leaving anybody else? Oh, and Virgil Donati is also featured.
Oh, wow. So part of that too, huh? Wow.
Sorry, Virgil.
You got that. That's fantastic. Good stuff. Did you want to slide into another song for us, gang?
Sure. Give me a second to set up.
Sure. Absolutely. Hope everybody's doing well. If you're just tuning in, Jim Masters here. We're live coming to from the East Coast, the New York area. That's where we are. And our guests are coming from the other side, the West Coast, Los Angeles. Kaylene Peoples is here. Brilliant vocalist, musician, composer. Former Miss California, flautist, and the extraordinary, legendary Bunny Brunel is here, renowned bassist, and of course, renowned guitarist Joe Caldreron is here as well, and they're gracing us with their wit and wisdom and great music as well on the Jim Masters Show Live. What's this song you have set up for us now, Kaylene?
This is called Spain.
I like it.
My Man CD, a Chick Corea tune that Buddy actually has performed with Chick for a long time. So he's featured on this on the actual album, and this is on My Man.
Yesterday, just a photograph of yesterday and all its edges folded across me. See it brown, yet it's all I have. I'm all passing by the script to its end. Brighter days, I can see such brighter days. When every song we sing is sung again, and now we know, this time it's for good. And we're lovers once again. And we'll more nearly. Yeah.
That is so delicious. Really nice. That is really, really nice. It's like butter. Really, really. So tell us about that one some more, Kaylene. And thanks. You guys are amazing together.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about that song a little bit more.
Oh, I'm sorry. Spain. Okay. First of all, I love Chicoria. When I was a little kid, I used to listen to Chicoria like all the time. And I always wanted to do that song. And it's not an easy tune. And I remember hearing Al Jarreau do it, and it kind of blew me away. In fact, Bunny performed with Al Jarreau on tour at Chicoria. But I noticed, I'm one of those people who likes to do things like nobody else is doing, and there weren't very many women aside from, what's that chick? Anyway, aside from her, and there was another woman from Greece that recorded the song, and I couldn't find any other recordings.
Gail Moran.
Gail Moran also recorded it. Yeah, Gail Moran. And I said, you know, not many women have recorded this. I think I would like to take a stab at this. And so it was one of those situations where, okay, I'm going to throw this down the repertoire. If I fail miserably, it won't make the album. But guess what?
Right.
Buddy came into the album project late. And I had already recorded the whole thing and decided to, because of his background and who he was and the fact of his relationship with that song, I decided to have him do the bass on that. And that's kind of how that happened.
That's fantastic. What inspires you? What are some of the things that inspire you, you know, during the course of the day, Kaylene, to compose music? How are you inspired? Are you always observing life? Are you always feeling things? Are you always picking up and connecting with vibes of life, the rhythm of life, nature, everything around you? What inspires you to pen such great music as well?
Well, a lot of times it's when I hear good music, I'm inspired by it. For instance, I'll give a couple examples. I'll give you Joe's. Listening to this couple Joe album. And I was like, oh, I could write a song that's so good. I would like to write something almost like an honor of, you know, like he has, the album is great. And so all the cuts are incredible. And I was pleasantly surprised because he didn't sell it to me because he's 10 years. And then Bunny's music, when I heard a lot of Bunny's music, it's fusion. I really got I'm going to be able to like that. Or other things that may inspire me is if I'm moved by an event or something, and I may want to maybe write based on that. A lot of times, I believe it's God-given, a lot of the stuff that I, as a composer, things will come. I'll hear full symphonies in my head. We're talking literal contrapuntal symphonies. I'm talking all the parts, all the orchestration is in there.
You'll hear it all. Wow.
Sometimes it just drives me crazy until I get it out.
Right.
So there's very many different things. Sometimes a good movie. I'll watch a movie and I'll hear the score and I'll be like, whoa. Or I'll hear somebody singing and I'm just like, oh, I love that song. Oh, I love the way they did that. I love the way that they... And that's kind of what it is. I'm just a big old fan of everything.
Of everything. Well, I was going to say, you've even tackled and have done some really unique versions of holiday tunes and Christmas music too, right?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Part of most of the crew's here except for the drummer, huh? Carol the Bells, yes. Carol the Bells. I was bored out of my freaking mind of the Christmas music. I'm like, no way. I just can't go. Crazy to this. I'm gonna tell you something. I'm actually quite proud of that Carol the Bells.
Oh, it's fantastic. I heard it. Yeah. It's cool.
how can I make this interesting? Because this, these tunes have been done so much, and I just, I don't know, I just, you know, you get there, and then a lot of it's vocal work, like the, you got to have the foundation of the music many times. Got it. You can't mess around too much.
No.
A standard.
Right.
You really have to have a foundation of the music. It's got to be 90% there, pretty much.
Right.
Except maybe unless you change some of the arrangement and you might go to this part instead of that part, but it still sounds like that tune.
Exactly.
I would say that the what makes it different a lot would be maybe what I came up with, like with the flute. I did some funky things on the flute. The guitar player did some really cool, like, surfing guitar. There's some crazy little guitar stuff. Buddy did some cute little solos, which was really, like, I feel bad for him because this is like a genius over here, and he had to play like these, like, kindergarten-style solos. You know, Joe.
And I bet he mastered it, too.
There's a tune, it's, a really cool tune that he did, but Sleigh Ride is one.
Sleigh Ride.
Got a cool solo one. And Chestnut. No, what's it? Chestnut. I knew Chestnut. What was it? What was the song that I did? Oh my God, I can't even think of the track listing right now, but he's soloing on a couple of those. And then we have guitar, which is Rich Mauser, by the way, is playing the guitar in that one. Joe's doing Nylon. And then Joe solos lovely solo on Carol Bells, and it's just killer. Yeah, it was just one of those things where I was bored out of my mind. I said, okay, I got it. Go on. You're not putting this out. You don't do that.
Right, exactly.
So I stayed up to like 6-7 in the morning sometimes, kind of these.
Wow.
Just open this up just to make it different. And get, you know, yeah, I get bored, you know. If I get bored with it, I don't want anybody else to. Like, you know, I like to give people some, like, when they're listening, like, I want it to go somewhere, you know?
Right, exactly.
Yeah. Not just do the tune, but, like, why don't you take you left for a minute? Well, let's close your eyes and envision you're on an airplane or on a flying saucer somewhere. You end up on another planet.
Right.
Right here on the bridge, we're going to go to Mars, you know?
Like, would you pick Mars or would you pick Venus? For some reason, I could see you fitting in beautifully to Venus.
Jupiter.
Jupiter.
Maybe Venus. I like Venus, yeah.
Well, I'm a Libra, so I'm always about balance and harmony and bringing people together because we're balance and harmony. And I'm not like extreme this, extreme that. I take elements of the extreme and I try to bring them together and harmonize everything because Libras like balance and harmony. And I tell people, I should have been born on Venus, the planet of love.
Yeah,
and then they're like, no, we need you. We need people like you on this planet, Earth, this crazy place. Otherwise, the place would implode. We need you to help us balance and harmonize things a bit.
I actually
agree
with that. We do need people like you. We do need the balance because you're right. Otherwise, it's not, it would be just completely disjointed, really. And you do have a calming way about you. You know, I'm picking it up, like, because I was a little frazzled when I got it. I'm much way more calmer now. Thank you for that.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that. And there's no copay. one of the viewers had asked, and I was thinking about this myself. Do you play several different kinds of flutes?
I really mostly play the sea flute and. I do play the piccolo, and I want to play alto, but I don't own an alto. I know how to play it, but I don't actually own it. But that's my next instrument purchase is an alto. So I do know how to play those three flutes. And I, you know what? Just to go back to something you said earlier, and I think somehow I went left on you. Someone had asked, do I play other instruments too, right? Someone else asked that?
Yeah, I asked that as well, too, if there are other instruments that you play.
Yeah.
And was the flute the first for you? Yeah.
Yeah, and I do play other instruments. I learned koto, the Japanese koto, when I was in college. And I do play piano. So those are...
You do piano.
I have a violin that sounds like dead cat, so we won't talk about that.
That's right. That's fantastic. You you guys have another tune there. We appreciate the gentlemen. The gentlemen are so patient. They're so. Did you give them some cookies or anything while they're waiting? a beer, a glass of wine.
Thank you so much for doing this with me, Joe and
Bunny. They are fantastic. You and I, we just for the audience to realize, you and I were on the phone last night, and we literally put this portion. You were coming on as a guest, and we were going to do some music, but to bring in Bunny and to bring in Joe, we put this all together pretty quickly last night, right? It's all this whole thing everybody's enjoying and they're commenting about and praising. We all put this together very quickly, just a matter of hours ago last night, right?
Yeah, it's true. This was completely extemporaneous. The good thing is Joe's so good and he knows my music.
I was going to say, you know why it's working? Because we're all professionals. That's what it is. You have lots of professionals here, gang. All right, Kaylene and Bunny and Joe. What is the next song that you have lined up for us?
It's off my All Jazzed Up album, the first jazz album I ever did. It's a popular one that people really like, and it's called When There's Samba. So give me 1 second.
Yes, absolutely. Gang, thanks for watching. Don't forget, if you're watching for the very first time, we love having you here. We would love it if you subscribe to our YouTube channel, Gym Masters TV. Click that red button. Show us some lovety. There's no cost for that. It lets us know you're enjoying all these episodes, all these content episodes that we have, over 700 now. And if you enjoy this episode, give us a like. There's a thumbs up button on our YouTube channel. You see it. It looks like that. Give us a like and leave a comment. Drop a comment on our YouTube channel as well. If you're enjoying this episode and all the episodes of the Gym Masters Show Live, a quick reminder, Tony Orlando is joining us live tomorrow. That's going to be fantastic. And John Davidson is with us on Wednesday. Now here's Kaylene, Bunny, and Joe with more music for us exclusively on the Gym Masters Show Live. Take it away, gang. Watch it. What is this one?
This is When There's Samba by Antonio Carlos Jobim.
This is just a little something built up on a single note.
water, no sound bound to follow. But the ring is steel and tear down. The new one is the consequence of the one we've just been through. As I'm about to be the unavoidable consequence. So many people have gone and dug and they have been all along. I used up every single note of the scale and I only sang one song. So I came back to my person as I'm listening back to my person. And it was the ocean who made me my soul what I teach.
That is awesome. I hope you have the windows open so the neighbors can hear this too. what is it like? I often ask a lot of the guests, especially the ones that come in that are in the musical world, and sometimes even actors and actresses too. When you're performing, when you're doing your thing, you sort of transport to another time and place. You're in a zone of sorts, right? Tell us what that feeling is like when you are, you know, in the middle of that type of sound and groove and vibe, and you're just doing your thing and everybody's playing off each other so beautifully. What is happening to you? Are you transported to another time and place, and are you in a certain zone at that moment?
It's like I'm picking up on everybody's energy while I'm on stage. And it does put me in another, into another internal place. Like once I'm connected in, once I really feel like I'm like, we're all together on the same page. We're all having the same emotions. We're all just like, it becomes another worldly experience for me. Yeah, it does. Many times when that happens. It doesn't always happen though.
There are times when it doesn't always happen, right? Exactly. Are you guys, is there any tours, anything coming up for like performances as things sort of, you know, are still reopening? And do you have that as a plan?
Yeah, we have. I'm not really doing too many performances right now, personally, like Kaylene Peoples. But I am also in Bunny's band, Bunny Brunel Cab. And we have a performance coming up at the Baked Potato. That's in July, July 15th. And then we have a jazz festival, the Oxnard Jazz Festival, which is September 11th.
Yeah.
And we have a couple of private gigs as well. I don't have a very big calendar date this year because I'm trying to get a movie edited, you know, finished and stuff like that.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah, concert. I took a step back to get some other projects completed. completed. So
you'll have to keep us posted about the movie and all. That's exciting.
That I do have. It's called. So we have the movie that I mentioned earlier, but there's also a show called Jazzing It Up with Kaylene. And it is sort of variety music, a little bit of comedy, and that stars Kevin Foster, who is a author, who's the writer for Monogamy, the TV show Monogamy. Chase Masterson is actually a guest interviewer, and Buddy Brunel is actually featured on the show, and then it's kind of like a little Dean Martin thing. It's like Dean Martin show.
Yeah, right.
Always singing and acting right. Silly. It's going to be a series on Prime, a mini series, and that's coming out later this year. And that's what I'm working. So I had to kind of put aside. This is the first, you're getting the exclusive on this because I haven't publicly announced this to anyone. But.
This is, we've got a graphic for that too, a JMS exclusive.
Yeah, exclusive. I have not announced it to the world at all. So this is a debut of that announcement. It's called Jazz. Right. And we're going to be hopefully doing an ongoing series, but it is a mini series that will be happening.
Very cool. Can never have enough of the Dean Martin vibe, kind of like
it's totally Dean Martin vibe,
right? Kind of like what we do here, sort of Johnny Carson, yes. Dick Cavett, Merv Griffin, Regis Philbin, Mike Douglas, old school entertainment lifestyle variety talk show series, but with a modern vibe, modern twist. And it's great to have all of these things because I think people are craving all of this. You know, they're craving, like it was a couple of viewers and guests that said that. We're bringing back here at the Jim Master Show, the lost art of conversation. We don't even, as you can tell, and you've watched other episodes. I don't even call these interviews. Interviews are, you come on for 7 minutes, tell us about the movie, tell us about the book, tell us about the CD, tell us about the website, see ya. Okay, who's the next one?
Yeah.
These are more conversations. There's no, you have no idea the questions that I was asking. There's no teleprompter. It's not scripted. We're weaving in and out of the music and the conversation and a totally different sort of easy vibe, which I really, really enjoy. And I think it brings in also the viewers who are enjoying it as well, which is fantastic. What are some other, I listed out all these fantastic things that you are currently doing, that you've done. You've also, you know, performed with Bobby Lyle, John Beasley, Jeff Goldblum. I mean, incredible.
Goodness, I am doing something. Making an appearance with Bobby Lyle.
I knew I was going to trigger that. Perfect.
Before I give you that answer, I left somebody out on Jazzing It Up with Kaylene Peoples. There's noise going on, so I can't hear myself.
So we can hear you. So, yep.
I forgot to mention Cameron Chamberlain, who's an award-winning podcaster for Beyond the Playlist. He's also off-site host for the Jazzing Up with Kaylene Peoples. He would have been upset about it. I didn't want to leave his name out. I have a show August 4th at my Grottos where I am a featured guest for Bobby Lyle.
The incredible Bobby Lyle. Yes, I have a lot of his music in my collection. Really spectacular. Yeah. What's it like? You've worked with him before, right?
Yeah, he actually composed a song for me on my Man album, and he's playing on Giant Steps with Hubert Laws and Buddy Brunel as well on that same album. And we did a concert back in, I guess it was 2019. It was Buddy Brunel was featured, Bobby Lyle was featured, they had their own sets, and then I was a guest on the Bobby Lyle show because I played in Cash, so I was in that, but that was a big show. Bobby will be collaborating with me on an upcoming project I'm doing. I'm having him reharmonize classical music for a flute album that I want to do. And that's going to be released next year in 2023.
That is exciting. You're going to have to definitely keep us posted on all these great things. And when the movie comes out and everything else, why do you love what you do so much? Obviously, there's lots of blessings and joys in your life. What are some of them that aid you in inspiring you to continue connecting, relating, and creating within the world of the arts for all of us, Kate?
I don't know. That's a really complicated question because I think I just like to. I don't know. Maybe I just get bored. And I have these harebrained ideas, and I just want to. I have these things that I want to do in my career musically. And hold on one second. Hold on. Hey guys. Sorry about that.
Is somebody coming in the room?
Yeah, it's okay. So I just want to say that
we've had cats jump on people's laps and birds land on their shoulders, and you know, when you're live, all that fun stuff happens. So was one of the blessings and joys in your life coming in the room?
So you know what keeps me going, right? What keeps you going? Good music keeps me going. Good production keeps me going. Good films keep me going. Talented people keep me going. When I see them, I just want to do. That's pretty much the short answer, the best answer. And I don't ever want to stop because there's so much in us and we're all creators.
Exactly right. When you surround yourself with creativity and when you have it, one of the other beautiful things about the work you do and I do is we get a chance to express elements of who we are as people through our talent, our experience, our enthusiasm for life, our passion. You get a chance to, you know, a lot of what you do in music and what I do as an on-air broadcaster and everything else, we're storytellers, and we're storytellers through our talent and our training and our art form, and also the expression of who Kaylene Peoples is, Jim Masters is, Bunny is, Joe is. It's a wonderful opportunity to be able to relate and connect with people through what we do, and sometimes at deeper levels than we even realize. I bet you've had many people write email, you see them at concerts or events, whatever it may be, and they tell you how much your music, what you do, touches them deeply. And that's really the icing on the cake, isn't it?
I think so. Whenever it feels really good when that happens. It feels good when people have been moved by something that I've done. In fact, it probably feels better than anything at all. I mean, every time I've done shows where I've walked down off stage and people will come up to me and they say, thank you, you've blessed me with your music. I'm like, oh, wow. You know, because I think in the way music is healing. And it does feel good.
Yeah.
Especially when it's personal.
Exactly. Right, exactly. Is there anything else that you haven't done yet, Kaylene, that you still want to do on that Kaylene, not bucket list, but things that are out there that you would still like to tackle, because you have done and still do so much?
I think the only thing, if you're gonna laugh, has nothing to do with entertainment.
Yeah, I think you should go into comedy because you're funny.
Watching The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel, and I gotta tell you, I think that somehow her shtick accidentally got into my shtick.
Yeah.
Because I love that show, and she's a comedian.
Would you like to appear on Broadway? I mean, would you like to be, if Broadway called, would you like to do Broadway?
I'll tell you what I do, what I want to do is this would be nice if this could appear on Broadway. I have a show. It's called Rite of Passage. And I think I sent you the CD. And I have a playwright named Lee Lee Simon, who's all, he's a, this guy has a Kennedy Center honor, so he's a major honor for actor playwright. And he's writing the play for me. And I'm going to have to learn how to act, really.
Wow.
It's music. It's a music.
Yeah, play. That's very cool.
That's probably the last chapter. Yeah, it's probably the last chapter. It's and it's based on the album A New Rite of Passage, and and I would love it if that made it to book.
How cool would that be, huh?
I don't know if I can act yet. This is a thing. We'll find out.
Right.
We will find out.
We will find out for sure. Absolutely.
I said, listen, I'm not an actress.
Got a couple of cool shots here too. That's a great shot.
Thank you.
That's a great expression as well. And there's Carol of the Bells. That's the EP too, right? Yeah. Great one. This is a great one we dug up too. That's a cool shot.
Thank you.
You remember where that was?
Yeah, that's kind of like a jazz club. That was shot by Lou Potter. Like one of the founding photographers of Florida Beach.
Really captured something extra special there. And of course, this, you're amazing on the flute. You really are. Absolutely amazing. Yeah. You know, and the way you were able to just go back and forth and the way that you do so, you know, seamlessly is incredible. What was, you remember this night?
Yeah, now this is part of that taping that you showed a little bit of.
Yes.
That's part of that. That was Romantic Bossanova tape that you did.
Cool and stuff. And of course, you know, playing with Bunny, who is truly a legend, and Joe, I mean, cool stuff, huh?
Yeah.
Really amazing stuff. This was really awesome, my friend. I mean, you really are, you're something else. And I would describe a firecracker in many ways and fantastic ways. And there's, again, the agenda. We were talking about that earlier and all the other things that you're doing. Somebody that usually hangs out with us here that pops in towards the latter part, Mr. George Burns is here with us. He pops in towards the end. There he is. And he said that you were absolutely amazing. He loved all the music. He was dancing with his martini. And he said, you knocked it out of the park, Kaylene, and Bunny and Joe.
Well, thank you so much for, thank you for the compliment. Yeah.
George is the best. He always pops in.
I love says, to already share with him because I so would.
Yeah. Sharing the billing with top billing with George Burns. Exactly. This was amazing. I hope, you know, the show met whatever expectations you had. You know, we figured, you and I, when we were chatting, we say that all the time. I tell the guests, you know, you can be on the show for as long as you're available, whether it's a half hour, you know, 40 minutes, an hour, whatever, because I don't put a clock on it. I'll go as long as, you know, the guests wants to go and is available and there's interaction with the viewers. And would you believe, seamlessly, it felt like a New York minute, we've gone almost 2 hours.
Oh, my goodness.
Could you believe that? Yeah, 2 hours of great conversation and music and entertainment and inspiration. I hope the show met whatever expectations you had, my friend, and you enjoyed the time with me as much as I absolutely have with you. This was fantastic.
I enjoyed it very much, and it's, as I said, it's an honor be on your show. I want to thank Pepper and John for making it possible, especially, and thank you so much for having me. I'm in good company. I mean, I was in Manchester the other day, and Lisa Long and some of the other people that you've interviewed. And I do watch it, and I'm actually a subscriber.
I appreciate that. I appreciate that.
Most successful, continue it.
I appreciate that. Great comments coming in. Thank you for joining us tonight, guys. Good luck in all you do in your future endeavors. Thank you for being here, Kaylene and everyone. That's Kathleen in New York City and Sherry watching in Kansas and Linda in Florida. Thank you, Kaylene, Bunny, and Joe for coming on Jim's show. And Dr. Cindy Banton, of course, cousin there. This was amazing. She loved it.
Cindy's my cousin, and she's you want to talk about somebody phenomenal? I've got to Google plug. She is not only a PhD, she owns a major company, and she's a runway model.
Really?
So it runs in the family.
I was just about to say, there's something in the water. Yes, absolutely.
Well, she's Jane. Absolutely. And a former beauty queen, too.
And now she's a lovety. Now she's a Gym Master Show lovety. Once you're a guest or once you watch, you're a lovety. I mean, I say it's all the guests. Grammys, Oscars, Tonys, Tellys, Peabodys, all of these great awards you can get. But how does it feel to be a lovety on the Gym Master Show Live? Are your feet tingling?
It is the highest high I've experienced so far.
Wow. As I always say, whenever anybody, my father has always said, and I always remember this too, still says it, whenever anybody says something kind or nice to you, ask them to please put it in writing and address it management. So Maureen in Arizona, it's been a fun evening. Thanks for being here, Jim and Kaylene. Jane watching in Sweden. Thanks, Kaylene, for being here tonight. Thanks, Jim. Our pleasure. Mary in Florida. Thanks, Kaylene, Bunny, and Joe. This was wonderful. Thank you to Crystal, and more smiles coming in from your cousin and Mona in New Orleans, Louisiana. Thanks for entertaining us tonight as well. Good stuff. This was terrific, my friend. Thanks for all the time, the wit and wisdom. Congratulations on the album. You know, all the exciting things that you have happening. You really are, you're a rock star in many ways. There is the album, Romantic Bossa Nova. That's available Spotify, Amazon, all the usual places,
Kaylin. The album cover is a little bit red in the background. Yeah, that's the album cover.
Right. So, but where can they get all your music? Where can they get your music if they want to, you know, add it to their library?
If you want to get it into, like, if you want to be able to just find it, I'm everywhere.
Yeah.
iTunes, well, Apple, is Apple Play now. Everything is streaming. It kind of sucks. So it's kind of difficult to purchase. But if you were to go to, I think on Amazon, you can buy it. And if you go to my website, you can also get all the information on everything you want to purchase.
And there it is, gang. KayleenePeoples.com. You can see it right there on the website and everywhere else. And this was amazing, my friend. Spread the word about our show. I would love that. Crystal says, thank you. You're very welcome, Crystal. And thanks for joining us, Kaylene. This was really terrific. I appreciate it. Lots of hearts coming in from your cousin. Thank you very much. Lovety Dr. Cindy. And thank Bunny and Joe for us as well. We really appreciate them joining you and putting this little mini concert set together for us here exclusively on the Gym Master Show. We really appreciate that. You are class all the way and extremely talented. We're going to keep the porch light on for you, Kaylene, and you're welcome back anytime. And hope you enjoyed yourself, and hope we get a chance to break bread and meet in person as well soon, East Coast, West Coast. It'll be terrific. Look forward to that.
I love that. Thank you so much.
You're great. Very welcome. Absolutely. Did you eat yet? I hope you ate. If you didn't, go eat.
And have a big old drink after that.
Right. You sang for your supper. Thanks, my friend. You're the best. It was really a pleasure, and I had a blast, and I'm glad you did as well. You take care and be well, okay?
Thank you so much.
Thanks. Take care. The incredible Kaylene Peoples joining us on the Gym Masters Show Live, Entertainment Lifestyle Roddy Talk Show Series. Hope you enjoyed. Again, you can definitely go to the website to learn more about all the great music, much more to come, lots of exciting things that are happening for Kaylene Peoples. And again, she also is brilliant at scoring fabulous music. She's got a film coming out as well that they're working on behind the scenes. Lots of great photos we showed here as well of Kaylene. And also, again, renowned, acclaimed Grammy nominated, two-time Grammy nominated, Bunny Brunel's with us as well. That was absolutely amazing to have him here. And Joe Caldreron was with us as well. There is Bunny, and he was fantastic. We really appreciate him hopping along, because he came in and Joe came in. We put this all together last night, and there's Joe. And so we added in two extra special guests with Bunny and Joe, which was amazing. And Kaylene, of course, amazing as well. And you can check out, again, all of the music at her website, KaylenePeoples.com. Lots of great music today, much more to come. And the Romantic Bossa Nova CD, you know, the music, download, whatever you're going to do, just get it. If you liked a little bit of what you heard on this episode, get some of it and add it to your collection. You're going to want it. You're going to love it. It's good stuff. Really, really cool. Now, we do have one video here that we're going to attempt to air, see what YouTube does with it. And we may have to take it out later, but at least you get a chance to hear it. Now we may have to take it out, but you heard her do one note samba, you know, with Bunny and Joe. Here's another version that she did that's really, really cool. This might be your one shot to see it right now when we play it, if we have to take it out, but at least you get a chance to see it now. And then I'll be back to chat some more. Here it is.
This is just a little samba built upon a single note. All the notes are bound to follow, but the root is still that note. Now this new one is the consequence of the one we've just been through, as I'm bound to be the unavoidable consequence of you. There's so many people who can talk and talk and just say nothing or nearly nothing. I have used up all the skill I know, and at the end there's nothing or nearly nothing. So I come back to my first note, and I must come back to you. Anyone who wants the whole show, re mi fa sol la ti do, he will find himself with a no-show. Better play that note, you know. This is just a little samba built upon one single This is just a little samba built up on a single note. Well, the notes are bound to follow, but the root is still that note. Now the new one is the consequence of the one we've just been through, as I'm bound to be the unavoidable consequence of you. So many people talk and they talk, they say nothing all day long. Of every single note of the scale, and I only sang one song. So I come back to my first note, as I must come back to you. Anyone who wants the whole show, re mi fa sol la ti do.
What can you say, gang? What can you say? That was absolutely incredible. Now you're definitely going to run out and get some of that music, huh? Was that not amazing? I could listen to that. I love that kind of sound. I can listen to that for hours. And she is absolutely, she is one of the best in the business. So talented, huh? There, you got a chance to hear her perform live exclusively here on the Jim Masters Show Live. But also you got a chance to see some of those clips. And, you know, we wanted to show you that now. Hopefully we can keep it on the show. We'll find out. But because YouTube gets a little tricky sometimes. But at least you got a chance to hear it now. And I wanted you to really get a good flavor with the good sound and everything. Really, really super talented. Kaylene Peoples, acclaimed, again, vocalist, musician, flautist, songwriter, composer, and so much more. And, you know, we need more music like that wafting through the air, sort of make us feel good. You know, everybody's all uptight lately and everybody's on edge and on the offense. We got to surround ourselves with some good vibes, good people, good food, good music, as much as we can. Sort of lowers the blood pressure and sort of keeps everybody, you know, more happy, more content, because the world is quite angry right now and everybody's just, you know, a lot of rage out there. And, you know, we're trying to balance it out here on the Jim Masters Show Live. So good stuff, gang. And thanks for the bevy of JMS comments that have been coming in all throughout the show. If you enjoyed this episode and all the episodes, there's something we would love for you to do. Give it a thumbs up. On our YouTube channel, there's a thumbs up icon there, and drop a comment, leave a comment on the actual YouTube channel. If you left a nice comment in chat, we love that. But what really helps us is when you comment on the YouTube channel, because YouTube sees that, we see that, and then YouTube takes the episode and they blast this episode out to even more people. That's right. So do that for us. We would love that. And of course, subscribe to the YouTube channel if you haven't. There's no cost. You just hit that red button, subscribe. It's on our YouTube channel, which is Gym Masters TV. The show is the Gym Masters Show Live. The channel is Gym Masters TV. And spread the word, share the lovety, tell everybody you know about our series. As you know, our every episode of our show is something different with all the conversations, the guests, the pop-up shows, the holiday theme shows, and everything we do. Look back and binge watch some of the episodes. We've got almost 700 shows we've done in just 2 years' time, live, and they're not 10-minute shows. So there's been a lot that we have done for all of you, and we absolutely love it. So spread the word, share the love today. Don't keep it a secret. Tell everybody, get on top of Mount Everest with a bullhorn and tell them, I love the Gym Masters Show, and I'm a lovety. That really helps us as well. Thanks for all the great comments. Jen Berry says, incredible night. Thank you. Thank you, Jen, watching in Pennsylvania, Kathleen in New York City. Lots of claps and happiness. Mona as well in Louisiana. Thank you very much, Mona, and everybody that's been commenting, and those who will comment later. A lot of people like to watch the episode later in the archive. If you missed any of this and you want to see it again, you can see it again right here on our YouTube channel, Gym Masters TV, in its entirety, and I hope you do enjoy it. I want to remind you, too, tomorrow, 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Pacific, the one and only Tony Orlando, Grammy-nominated gold and platinum-selling music legend and entertainer, will be with us. Last night, Melissa Manchester was here. If you missed that episode, that was her second visit, her return visit to the Gym Masters Show. We loved having her here. Wednesday, the incomparable John Davidson is here, legendary TV game show host, singer, songwriter, actor, entertainer extraordinaire. And coming up on July 13th, legendary comedian, actress, singer Barbara Brighton's going to be here as well, live from Vegas. She is known for doing an epic Joan Rivers and so much more, gang. This is just the short list. So many more folks we have coming up. And if you missed any of the others before, make sure that you check out and binge watch all the episodes. So as you guys know, we don't say goodbye. We just say see you later. Sláinte, ciao, cheers, shalom, sayonara, hasta la vista, and all the rest. And you guys be well, take care of one another, and love one another. And you're always welcome here at the Gym Masters Show Live. We'll keep the porch light on for all of you. Mona says, love and hugs to all you lovities. And Jim, and thanks again. Right back at you. And good night, beautiful people. Sleep well and have a fantabulous Tuesday. Love and hugs from Sherry in Kansas, USA. All right, gang. Good to see you. Thanks for spending time with us once again on the Gym Masters Show Live. We love you all. Take care. Be well. And we'll see you on the next one. For those that are watching live, Tony Orlando tomorrow night. For those that are watching this Memorex, meaning in the archives, stay right here. Another episode comes right up on our YouTube channel, Gym Masters TV. Be well. We'll see you again next time. Thanks for being with us. Cheers.